I'm Bill Wong with Electronic Design. And Paul, could you tell us a little about time of flight sensors and why 3D LiDAR is taking off at this point?
Well, great. Thanks for having me. Yeah, time of flight is exciting. It's an old technology, been around forever. One of the things that makes it really appealing is it's super low cost, you know. Time of flight versus a laser-based scanning LiDAR, it's exponentially cheaper. But where time of flight has struggled is in bright sunlight and getting any real range out of it, more than a couple of meters. And that's where PreAct came in. And, you know, we consider ourselves a fully software-defined LiDAR. So every bit of this LiDAR is changeable over the air, or, you know, if you plug in a USB cable to it. So you can change any of the algorithms, how it's processed, you know, pretty much everything but the resolution can change. And with these advanced algorithms that we've developed, we're able to deal with the bright sunlight, the reflective objects, range rollover, all the things that have hampered time of flight in the past. And that's why we're kind of unique in this space. We now get in our lowest end design, 10 meters range with 10% reflectivity. So it's pretty powerful, and it's got very, it's less than 2%, range inaccuracy, range accuracy is plus or minus 2%.
Very good. Now, you're actually announcing a lot of new products that are taking advantage of this technology. Could you tell us about those?
Sure. Yeah. So we now have the Mojave unit, which is this one. This is available for sale today on all the main distributors out there, including Amazon. But we will be announcing Sahara, which is a more automotive grade and outdoor, like IP69K rated sensor, has a lot more power and a lot more range, and more processing capability. We'll also be announcing Moab, which incorporates a GPU and a much more powerful processor and increased memory, so that we can incorporate some of our AI-based algorithms on the edge and make decisions on the edge and just communicate little messages back to wherever the host is, so that you're not transmitting, you know, point clouds or video images or anything like that. And then the last one is Borrego, and that is for cargo monitoring. Mm-hmm. So big shippers like Amazon or Walmart, that they like to know in real time how much cargo is in their truck trailers, how much open space there is on the floor, if they're shipping pallets, things like that. Has the cargo fallen over? It's kind of theft control. There's a number of things. And that Borrego is primarily for that, as well as some security applications.
Well, it sounds like you have quite a number of products, but what is the range and resolution, those kind of figures for each one of those?
Yeah, so... It's kind of a deceptive thing for us. We operate around 20 frames per second, up to 30 frames per second, depending on which LiDAR we're talking about. The resolution is quarter VGA, mm-hmm. 320 by 240. However, every image output that we do is actually the collection of five different frames. And we do a lot of processing of those five frames before we output one. So what you get is this super perfect point cloud with great range accuracy. Sometimes people will go, oh, well, you know, an Intel RealSense or, whatever TI chip, you know, has 1 or 2 megapixels. But you compare them side by side and you're like, you know, holy crap, the PreAct point cloud looks 10 times better than the RealSense point cloud, you know, things like that, because we do so much processing before we output a single frame. We do all that heavy lifting for our customers, as opposed to making them do a lot of processing of what comes out of our competitors' LiDARs.
Mm-hmm. So is there a lot of customizable programming available for something like Mojave, or is that something that Moab has?
Well, Mojave has the ability to run some algorithms on the edge,
mm-hmm.
basic stuff, nothing too significant. This is primarily designed for robotics, some kind of security and retail applications, and academia and research and stuff like that. So most of those solutions use a central compute,
mm-hmm.
So they don't even want it on the edge. So they just want a good clean point cloud that can detect objects, things like that.
So what types of models can be run on Moab then?
Oh, very advanced things. So we do, Moab was initially developed for our patient monitoring solutions. So we work with healthcare providers to provide a sensor that goes into nursing home or hospital rooms to monitor patients. And one, it's LiDAR is great for it because it's GDPR compliant. You know, you're not getting a camera image. You know, nobody wants, somebody videotaping or watching their, grandmother's laying in bed all day or that, that's just kind of creepy, So by using a point cloud, there's no personally identifiable data and you get the depth. So we can tell, it's very plug and play. So you mount it in the ceiling and using our AI-based algorithms, it automatically knows, oh, that's a bed, that's a chair, that's a window, that's a door, that's the floor. So there's no setup or calibration required. It just kind of knows these things. And then it knows what a person looks like and can detect the depth. So even just laying on the bed, it knows the difference in depth and knows, okay, the patient's lying in the bed, they're standing now, they're sitting in a chair, they walked to the bathroom, they fell on the floor. It can detect if there's been violence. It does kind of people counting. So it knows when other people come into the room.
Mm-hmm.
So these are all things that healthcare providers want. And especially in these days of staffing shortages, it's critical. So pretty complex algorithms are residing on Moab.
Quite impressive. Now, you also have a sensor ecosystem. Can you tell us what that means and how it works?
Sure. Well, there's two ways to look at it. There's, like I described for Moab, where we've developed these algorithms for our customer base and provide, the hardware and the software that does the job for them. However, we're also working with many systems integrators, and we have a user portal where they can update and post stuff, kind of like a mini GitHub, if you will.
Mm-hmm.
And then we also have the creator tool, which is, we bought an AI company, machine vision AI company out of Barcelona last year, and incorporated them into our ecosystem. So we can license that out to our customers and they can quickly develop their own algorithms for anything from like gesture control to object detection and tracking, things like that. Or they can hire us to help them develop these algorithms.
Well, thanks, Paul, for filling us in on PreAct's time of flight technology. It's really interesting. Thank you.